crazy.
Yo, real talk. Can I stop bullshitting y'all? Real talk though.
What?
Everyone's joking about. I just saw the clip of Jacquees and Chris Brown in the studio.
Oh.
Jacquees, niggas friend Jacquees is gonna have. He's gonna have a career.
Yeah.
For sure.
The song is like it's still it's sound like everything else, but the way he's singing. First of all, you can tell he's a Chris Brown fan.
Yeah.
But he sounds like.
He sound like a Donnell Jones.
He sound like Donnell Jones. Like, so, there's no dude singing male R&B.
The most important thing, win, though, watch. The ladies are going to love him.
They're going to love him.
They already do.
Hood niggas that can kind of sing.
And who talk
right.
that shit.
Right.
And he's definitely talking that shit. Like, right. I heard it and I was kind of like, but I don't hear where it sounds. Like, you know, I'll look for a reason to find the fault. I'm like, uh-huh. I don't hear nothing that's really, like,
yeah.
wrong here. So, you know.
He say he the king.
He say he the king. Is he the king to you, Phil? Is Jacquees the king?
Of this generation.
Of this generation.
I like Jacquees. I think he's on his way to being a prince.
A prince okay. of what is the question?
Motherfucking prince.
Be specific with your word, my man.
Prince of ribs and blunts.
Ribs and
ribs
and
okay. Oh my God!
Where we start? We starting to. What's the first shit we gonna kick into?
I don't know, but we on some shit, right? I have a serious question. Since you said that though, like, who actually is the fucking king of R&B then? Who really is? Let's cut the bullshit.
I mean, legal matters aside, for me, it's R. Kelly.
Okay. See, my opinion is that I think it's easy. Y'all act like Stevie Wonder's not alive.
Right.
And I just feel like Stevie is the true king of R&B. That nigga did everything.
I think they don't necessarily classify Stevie as R&B.
They classify
him as rock and roll.
Yeah.
So he don't get that title like that. But when you talking about some true R&B.
He's so R&B though. Like I know he's crossover. Like Stevie is Stevie everyone knows him, but like yo, like but like when I was a kid, Stevie was so black. In the best way possible. I mean, like,
it is true. He was black.
So black, yo. Like, I didn't see him as like even how people view like Michael and Whitney as crossover artists.
Yeah,
Stevie was black, and right. it made you feel good about being black.
Yeah.
And all them songs, there's the songs that everyone knows, but then there's a good chunk of Stevie that's just some barbecue ass music.
There's a whole song on Songs in the Key of Life,
yeah.
where he's got kids shouting out. Black heroes.
Yeah.
Like he was one of the first.
And the whole and Happy Birthday, which was from
right.
He was know. Always talking about the ghetto.
We so crazy.
Who's the superstars of the day?
Beyonce,
Rihanna.
Tinashe.
You got jokes, dude.
Y'all leave little TT alone.
TT out of this. This is grown folks' business right here. Superstars, like black artists.
Like people who walk into a room and you feel like, oh shit, like.
Beyonce and Rihanna, for sure.
Yeah.
But then you have to swing over to the hip hop side for the rest of it.
Yeah.
No men in R&B.
Mm-mm.
Chris Brown a star.
Chris Brown.
Breezy. Is
a star.
Yeah, Breezy.
Chris Brown.
I put
Chris Brown for sure, for sure, for sure.
But everybody else is trying to low key be a rapper,
pretty much.
In quote unquote R&B, I mean there are singers. There
but
are
let's also define. Okay, so let's be clear because everyone calls themselves a superstar now, and lots of people are shutting down big venues and popular and got a million mm-hmm. whatever followers. So it's a superstar is, in my opinion, is rarefied air. You're talking about like. Not just you're famous, because that's easy now.
Right.
And not just you have numbers or you sold records. And you're talking about like you said, like, from my experience, and I think all of us here have been around a lot of artists from all genres, there's like certain people suck all the air out of the room.
Mm-hmm.
Like, there's certain people that, as soon as they walk, you don't have to see them, but before you even know that they're in it, you just know something has entered the room.
Right.
So that's the difference. Yeah,
that's,
yeah.
You that's feel how it was when I met Seal.
Seal was a superstar.
Wow.
He walked in the studio and I just felt like the heavens opened. You know what I'm saying? And he hadn't really said nothing. He was just like his presence, his aura was like, he's a super duper, super duper star.
Superstar.
That's how I felt when I met Anita Baker.
A superstar.
Like, she walked into the bank that I was working at, and it was like...
She was cashing them checks, damn it.
She was depositing that coin.
She was depositing that fucking coin. I like it.
Not Anita Baker, and I just had to, like... I literally had to go in my office and close like it was a sliding
door. Compose yourself?
And, like, all right, Tamone, get it together. Like, it was bad.
But this is good though. Let's separate the mice from the men.
Yeah.
Like, who are the superstars?
Superstars.
No bullshit. Like, let's not be polite. We said Beyonce and Rihanna, right?
Mm-hmm.
And we said Chris,
mm-hmm.
right? Phil. Any genre, it don't matter.
I think even with everything that's going on in the last few years, Usher is a superstar. I think.
Usher. You know, it's tricky with me with Usher because.
Holy shit. Yo, that pregnant pause though.
That pause was disrespectful.
So disrespectful.
Put some respect on Usher.
Now, some of the stuff he's doing now is a little
questionable. Come
on.
But I mean, this man had probably the best selling record.
It's a diamond record.
Yeah.
Best selling record.
I think it's one of the last diamond records.
Diamonds are forever.
Yeah, no.
He's a star forever because of it.
Okay, I mean, Usher, I respect Usher. I mean, he's an artist. When I grew up in my teens, Usher was like, yo, he came out with the, Before You Make Me Wanna, Can You Get With It? With,
yeah.
You know, Devontae's.
Come
on, man. What
is like that?
Think of You,
yeah,
The
man.
Many Ways, yeah. All those records.
Just Call Me a Mac.
We sound crazy.
Question, favorite Anita Baker song?
Oh,
More Than You Know from Ooh. Compositions. Ooh. That whole album, that's like a hidden gem in her catalog. Like, no one really talks about that.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody talks about Rapture.
Yeah.
Get on Compositions. You got More Than You Know.
He's like, get on Compositions.
More Than You Know, No One to Blame, Whatever It Takes.
Fairy Tales.
Fairy Tales is amazing.
Like, that whole, it's 9 songs.
Very.
Just the way the song come in. And it sounds even better on vinyl. Like,
you have the vinyl?
Yes.
You have the vinyl for real?
Yes.
Man. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Like, this is the epitome of Quiet Storm, man. Like, the late 80s.
Damn, I love Anita Baker so much. Oh my God, she's the best.
Yo, that intro is so classic. It's so epic. She was rock and roll.
Hold on. Stop it for a second, Phil. Let's just say this because we all share this experience together. We saw Anita Baker at the Ryman.
Yes.
Oh, man.
Listen.
The best show I've ever been to.
The best concert I've ever seen.
It's
the feeling in that room, my dude.
And I've seen a lot of people. It's the best show.
Amazing. I went both nights.
You went both? Did you go both nights, Tamone?
No, I went to the show that
we saw you, right?
Yeah, we saw you.
And then I went to a show in Atlanta.
Dude, listen. The way she delivered those records, that room felt like family.
Yeah, man.
We were all just swaying together, and mm-hmm. she was crying and feeling. Remember, she was crying at the end to
yeah.
Yeah, man.
Was it Giving You the Best That I Got?
Giving You the Best, yeah.
Dude, I left there on a cloud 109.
Yeah.
Like, it was crazy. Anita.
Favorite? Your favorite is More Than You Know. What's your favorite?
Today, on this day, my favorite Anita Baker song would be probably Been So Long.
Ooh.
Today. Loving it, baby. Oh. Yeah, man.
Been so long,
you see.
So you
feel what I'm saying to you?
Yeah.
won't be neglected. I won't be denied. Pleasure of your smile, I think you take for granted.
Come on.
I'll always be here just because I love you. It doesn't mean I won't disappear.
Been so long,
I'm missing you, baby.
Been so long,
I'm missing you, baby.
I love it, man.
Man, that's good. Oh boy!
Shout out to Michael J. Powell, who was
Michael J. Powell,
like her right hand man on those first couple.
Drop the wiki info. You know,
we gotta shout out the people that were part of the history.
I've never met Michael. I would love to meet Michael just to hear from his point of view, just that whole process of recording a classic. Like,
because she's one of those dope artists where, like, this is my opinion of the best artists. You can't really. As a person that spent a lot of time in the studio, I can usually hear where the song starts, where it begins, how they recorded it.
Right.
The whole process. And there's very few artists where I hear it, I'm like, I don't know how they wrote the song. I don't know how they recorded it. I don't know how that magic ended up on. Like, I would want to ask the same thing, because her music is so fantasy and seamless that you can't, it doesn't sound like a session. It don't sound like a studio session. It just sounds like.
It's perfect music.
Magic happened.
It's perfect. Like, you listen to, like, the production and the vocal arrangement and the quality of her voice and her delivery, just the whole thing. It's just like perfect music.
Phil, you know what I'm saying? Like you, a lot of, I'm definitely gonna sound like the old man, but the artist now, you hear this single and it sounds like, okay, I know that you put these people together and it's recording this kind of studio and it's mixed and mastered by fill in the blanks and it's gonna go to radio at this time of year, and like the whole thing, it just feels like a formula.
Anita's records felt like just a fucking vibe, man.
You
like
don't even know where
Rapture, just
live rhythm section.
I'm like, what planet did this come from, because I don't know where it begins or ends. It's just, and very, she's one of them artists, even when she was doing it live, I still was like, but how did you figure out how to do it this way? How'd you master this sound? Because there's no
Chuck, favorite Anita Baker song?
Fairy Tales.
Woo!
You didn't have to hesitate, did you? You just knew? Okay.
That piano solo is crazy, man.
True.
And the album version is like killer.
Yeah.
Because there's an extended portion at the end of the record.
Yeah.
Ha! And she killed us live at the show. This live was nuts.
The piano player is killing the whole thing.
Listen.
Song.
If you don't want to get dressed up, you want to put on your hard bottom shoes for this shit, then you're not have a soul. It's hard bottom music.
I can remember stories, those things my mother said. She told me.
You feel me, Phil? This is hard bottom shoes and champagne.
It's that burgundy Lexus we be talking about. With the cool air conditioning, you feel me?
You know what I'm saying? Come on.
That Dina, what's his name? Dennis Haysbury.
This Dennis Haysbury.
Yeah, man.
This is that Phoenix, like, this is that, like, picking Savannah up from the airport and waiting to exhale shit right here. You know what I'm saying? Dude, that's what that is.
Yeah, man.
Come on, that's a vibe.
That's the good life.
That's, you pick up your girl and she has like a fur stole on. You know what I'm saying? Just something over her shoulders with some fur. Come on, man. That's classic. That's classy black shit.
More of that. My favorite Anita Baker song, I'm not even going to say it. I just rather give
it
a little.
Play it.
I'd rather, instead of saying it, I'd rather just play it, because you're going to know it on the first.
You can play it better than you can say it. Live.
You bring me joy?
Yeah, man. I can't front. You bring me joy, my dude.
You bring me joy.
Oh,
when I'm down.
Yeah, man.
Yes, sir.
Joy.
piano player?
Yeah, man.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
What live performance? Can you send me that link? Because that piano player is killing me. He's killing me over here. Jesus, like, Lord.
Share, Phil. Come on, man. Come on, man.
Sharing is caring.
I just want that shelved Anita Baker album with the Lately record on there that we never got.
Mm. That's right.
Only Forever that was supposed to come out in 2012 on Blue Note. Anita, what's up?
What's up? What's up?
He was like, when you dropping the goods?
Drop that mixtape on us, Anita. Come on.
Yeah.
I think you'll hear my album first, Tamone. I don't think we'll... Maybe Anita have to give us a private listening
session.
Come on,
Anita.
We want to hear it, Anita.
She don't play though. She knows her business. She's not letting her stuff get used improperly. She's not letting.
I love that though.
I love it.
Yeah, man.
But Anita's like, my shit is on Apple, Tidal,
and that's it.
That's it.
But
OG, that's an OG.
That's OG, and she right.
But given the recent circumstances,
that's what I'm saying. She's right.
With Spotify trying to sue songwriters, I'm like. Maybe she had it figured out. Same thing Prince was saying. Like, maybe she had it figured out. Like, do your homework and know literally where you're actually getting paid from and who's not just using you for your art. And I'm tempted right now, and I'm watching a lot of my peers do the same thing, pull off of Spotify for the same reason. But I'm like, she was, like, all about getting paid.
Yeah, man.
When it wasn't cool to be thinking about that stuff. And she's still strong as ever, selling out everywhere she goes and has a strong catalog that's not watered down. So maybe she definitely was right.
Yeah.
Should have listened to Anita, y'all. Hashtag should listen to Anita.
Anita.
Anita. Anita Applebaum said, you got to put me on.
Hey.
We sound crazy.
So let me flip the script and ask a totally opposite question then.
Mm-hmm.
And this is something that I've done a couple of times and the conversation always gets really juicy. So we agree we all love Anita Baker. And I think that's something that everyone would agree with in public. So I always have to ask this question to people for shock value. So we're all technically in the music industry. So there's certain things that you would not admit to, let's say at an industry party, because there's certain artists that are off limits to not like. And I don't want to hate on anyone, but let's just keep it real. Like, who's an artist that you wouldn't admit in mixed company that you're just not crazy about? That everyone would be super shocked by. This can't be like someone that's come out in the last 2 years and dropped two mixtapes. I mean, like, close to, if not definitely, legend status. Like, let's shock, like try to knock each other's socks off. Like, who's that person that I would be shocked, Phil, Tamone, Chuck, that you really don't love?
For me, it's Philionaire.
Billionaire, the billionaire.
He said, "At billionaire."
At again, socials.
At me.
If you want to.
At me if you want to. Let's fight about this.
Elton John.
We sound crazy.
Okay. All right.
That's a hard pill.
That's a hard one.
Damn, man. Just, like, you can't just come and swing. That was a whole crispy two piece in the first answer.
Man.
All right.
I mean, I get it, but also, and here's the thing: I was in the movie theater a few weeks ago, seeing The Green Book. Cause I'm super late. I'm just saying it. So I went, and then the trailers, they were showing the new Elton John movie, and I was like, "Yeah, I won't be seeing this."
You're tripping.
I'm not interested.
You sound crazy right now. Rocket Man, Yellow Brick Road.
Yellow Brick Road, one of the best songs.
Candle
all
in the Wind.
Of all time.
Yo, hold on. The whole Lion King soundtrack.
Right.
What's the song that Mary sampled? The Benny
and the Jets.
Yeah, that was dope. Yeah. It's nice. Nice song. I like
He's
it.
He's on That's What Friends Are For.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, we like him on Dion's song. That was great.
He's smiling.
Oh, so Dion's song.
I'm just saying, I respect Elton John. But he's not one of my favorites. I don't think I have anything of his in my playlist outside of That's What Friends Are For. Just not for me. I think it's overrated. Like, I'm more of Stevie, you know, that's a legend to me. But Elton John, yeah, I think it's okay. I get it.
Cool. Yeah.
Legend. Okay. I think. Get it.
You are killing me right now, my dude.
I understand.
I don't understand, damn it.
I mean, I don't agree, but I understand.
Right. It's not
people.
Right, but it's okay.
We all got people right. Like that.
Right. Cool. Who wants to go next?
Tamone, who you feeling
Come on,
like?
Tamone. Don't disappoint.
So this is somebody that I've been saying that I need to, like, sit down and, like, go through their catalog, and I just... To be honest, I just haven't felt compelled to. Y'all don't don't try to cancel culture. Don't try to cancel me on this, but Marvin Gaye.
What?
Like, there are certain songs that sidebar, I still rock with.
Phil just air punched you.
I was about to say, you probably should have connected on his arm on that one.
Right.
But like, when I think of artists where I know Stevie, like, deep album cuts. I know Whitney, deep album cuts. I know Anita, deep album cuts. When I think of Marvin Gaye, I'm like, I've never really gotten into that man's catalog. That's not to say that he's like horrible or anything, because he was a damn good artist. But
a damn good artist.
But
he's one of the greatest artists.
But
he said like it was like,
I was never compelled to like, oh my God, I gotta figure out like his whole catalog. Like Stevie Wonder, to this day, I'm still educating myself and feel like I have to on like Talking Book and Songs in the Key of Life and Fulfilling This First Finale. Like I know his album titles. I don't know that about Marvin.
Tamone.
Oh my
Tamone. If I had to choose, I would choose Stevie over Marvin.
Oh my damn.
So Tamone, here's what I'm gonna do for you. I'm gonna commit. You hear this?
This is guys, public this? Knowledge.
Tamone does an amazing job of sending around like really great playlists. Are you all in the distro list? And we gotta make sure if you're not, but he does an amazing job of these amazing playlists. I'm gonna compile a Marvin Gaye playlist.
Okay.
Because I need you to really understand the level of excellence. Marvin Gaye?
Marvin.
I mean, I rock with now I know some deep album cuts like If I Should Die Tonight. It's not like I know who Marvin Gaye is and I know his music, but when I think of artists that I really devote time to and sit in the middle of my floor in my apartment and like really go in, like Stevie Wonder, I'll pull all of his albums out in my vinyl collection and I'll spread them out. And I'm like literally looking at the credits, wondering who played what, you know, that kind of thing. Marvin Gaye, I haven't gotten to that point. That's not to say that I won't get to that point, but I just, growing up, I was never like Marvin Gaye, you know, it's.
Apparently Robin Thicke wasn't either.
Oh. That part. I wasn't ready, but I mean, call it like it is.
It is what it is. But Marvin Gaye, Tamone, I owe you a playlist.
Okay.
I owe you a playlist.
Shit, dude.
Marvin. So many gems.
Marvin.
But some people may argue that about me saying Elton John, in all fairness. So I put him in the same bracket for me, like with Donny Hathaway and Stevie.
See,
and
I choose Donny Hathaway and Stevie over Marvin.
Okay.
Like those two, for me, like I grew up singing. So when I think of people that I listen to try to practice, I don't look at Marvin Gaye. I look at Donny Hathaway because his inflections and the way he belted certain songs and you felt where he was coming from. As a 15-year-old, I didn't necessarily listen to Marvin Gaye to get that. And so I think that's kind of carried over into my adulthood. So, but
I don't understand, but I forgive you. All right, I feel like I'm definitely asking for it with this one.
Ooh.
I'm asking for it.
Oh, drum roll, please.
I'm asking for it. Feel ready to throw a phone at me. All right, so I think part of it's because I'm such an East Coast kid.
Yeah.
And I grew up on 80s and 90s hip hop.
Mm.
There's definitely a few songs that are undeniable that the whole world loves, but I don't have a fascination for Tupac.
What? Mm-hmm. Claude Lethulius Cornelius Kelly. What are you talking about right now? Tupac.
I'm just so I'm so Biggie. I'm so
no, I love B.
I was so East Coast with my shit. And the thing about it was, as an adult who understands like protest and standing for what you believe in and everything like that, I understand him now as a revolutionary, but I missed the whole pandemonium of Tupac when it was happening. So I can look back now as a historical figure, like, yeah, wow, what a young guy that said some dope stuff. But like, I don't feel it the way people feel it because I didn't feel it at the time. So I respect him, but I don't own a Tupac album.
Claude.
I never have. I don't.
Claude,
think.
Come on, you got to have something.
I don't.
Tupac
I mean, I'm sure. I mean, I saw it on TV all the time, so it wasn't like I was. I don't know. I know everything that I know what's up. I'm not saying I don't know what's up, but I'm just saying like I wasn't running. I never, ever, ever. I don't think I've ever bought a Tupac. Like taking my money as a kid or a dumb, but like I got to buy Tupac's album. I didn't have any of them. I knew all the singles because how could you not? But he's never been part of my catalog, my musical catalog, ever.
Tupac Shakur, are you kidding me right now?
I'm dead ass.
He's in my top five.
As an actor, I could definitely give you credit. Like, I fuck with him as an actor in many, many ways. Many movies I love that he's in. But as an artist, it was never my thing. And I know that sounds crazy because he's like Black Jesus to most people.
I'm one of them. Like,
he's Black Jesus, so.
I just don't get it, Chuck. Please don't tell me you got something against Martin Luther King, because right now this is crazy.
I mean, I'm probably gonna get in trouble for mine too, but after Vision of Love, you know, I
go ahead and say it, bro. Go ahead and say it.
I kind of lost Sister Mariah. You
know? After Vision of Love, though,
I had a vision,
and then you lost
for
love?
Sister Mariah, and it wasn't with ODB. I'm just gonna say that. You know what I'm saying?
You lost the love. You had the vision, but lost the love.
I just thought we was going somewhere way more musical. You know what I'm saying? That's you. Chuck, you know what I mean?
So you mean Mariah Carey? Oh my God!
So you didn't want hip hop Mariah?
I didn't want hip hop Mariah.
Got it. There's a lot of people
because,
like that though.
Because like,
and I get it.
Like she was so brilliant. You know what I'm saying? Like
when I understand that.
I hate when really musical artists can kind of dumb themselves down to fit into a culture. Like hip hop,
I love Mariah. I like Mariah is.
I love the star. I just, you know what I'm saying.
She's a star. She's Aries too. I love
Christmas Mariah.
She lost me.
Come on, Christmas Mariah. I just think Mariah Carey. Again, and y'all could argue me down on mine, but I just think that Mariah is one of the. She's a star, and she's one of my favorites.
Superstar.
She's had like, how many number ones? You know, on the Billboard chart, record breaking. I mean, she's Mariah.
I'm talking about the musical nerd in me wanting Mariah to do more. That's where it happened, and it didn't happen.
You gotta respect his opinion.
I respect it. This is, I just
you over here
like
popping up by Elton John and shit. So you know what I'm saying? Like, you gotta respect that. You gotta respect my man's opinion.
No, I do.
Right here.
So Elton John.
Marvin Gaye,
Tupac Shakur, and Mariah Carey.
we sound crazy. I got a question. What songs nowadays could our, like, if you got nieces, nephews, kids, or whatever, like, what songs are out now where they could sing in talent shows? Like, talent show type songs. Like,
well, you just went to a talent show.
Greatest Love of All.
Yeah, my nephew had a talent show in East St. Louis, in Belleville, Illinois, last week, and I went out there to see him play the bass. He did Stevie Wonder, but the only current song that they did was the Her song, Focus on Me.
Y'all don't think that's a problem?
Yeah, of course it's a problem.
A problem.
Like the fact that we don't have songs now that kids can take and interpret for themselves.
Literally not even trying to plug, but real talk, that's literally the reason why we started the Shindellas.
Dope.
Literally. Because we were like, girls,
dope.
I remember all the girls when I was young fighting over whether they should be Brandy's part or Monica's part, or which harmony in Destiny's Child, or which harmony in SWV or whatever. And that was like a big part of like you learning whether you were alto, soprano, could you sing, if you couldn't sing at all.
Yeah.
And we just wanted that whole vibe back because there really isn't songs that make boys or girls want to sing or choose a style. Like there was, you could decide whether you want to sing like Mary or sing like Faith or sing like Brandy or sing like Joe or sing like R. Kelly or sing like whoever, that like your vibrato change or the way you sang your phrases. That just doesn't exist no more. So it's a huge problem to me. But when, even online, people are all covering Her because it's the only thing that's melodic.
The only thing.
That's crazy.
And I saw a video on Facebook of like my cousins, and they were like doing this little dance to that Tatiana song, and I'm just like, okay, so this is where we've gone. Like,
well, yeah, that's where we are now.
I like Tatiana.
Here go Phil, like, but hold on now.
I like Tatiana.
We sound crazy.
Hey, dude, I had to tell you, this is one of my favorites from Chrisette. Can I play it?
Yeah.
Just a little snip.
Please do.
Young Chuck Harmon.
A young Chuck in his prime.
And then it comes to me like an epiphany.
yo, can y'all just pay Chuckers money real fast, please? Can you run him his money?
That's how I came into business.
This, how, this, how, this is how I kicked in the door, waving the 4-4.
I came waving the 4-4, boy.
Album in the country that when it came out. Waiting for it to number one album.
This did what? 500,000?
Yeah.
This went gold, didn't it?
Yeah. You know what the crazy thing is? Didn't even fully see it through. There was six singles on that album. To be had, like, full off.
How many singles came off?
Two? Three? Two?
They didn't even.
There was no video for Blame It On Me.
For Blame It On Me.
What?
There was no video for Blame It On Me. And.
And there was, that shit.
I was in college in Columbia, South Carolina.
There was no video.
That was one of the first songs we wrote together.
That was one of the first ones we did in the studio.
Blame It On Me?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's fucking magic.
Sometimes you can work it out. Sometimes you can't. Sometimes you're forced to watch everything fall apart inside of your hands. Sometimes leaving is easy.
It's called the Esther Rolle Award for Black Excellence. And we should definitely, some of y'all will know what Esther Rolle is because y'all definitely watch Good Times and many other things. But it's we love Esther Rolle, not only because she's an amazing actress, you see, but because she has a gospel album.
She has a gospel album.
Oh, it's Savoy Records.
Can I ask, because Tamone schooled me. I'm walking around with it. Tamone is playing Esther Rolle.
Oh, God. Wait, Tamone's playing in the office?
Tamone's playing Esther Rolle in the office. And I said, what is that?
Who's playing Esther Rolle?
Why would you play in the office, my dude? Why?
I don't know. I was on YouTube one day, and it just, like, you know how on the side, it'll give you, like, suggestions or whatever. And, I mean, I was like, Esther Rolle had an album, and I clicked on it, and she was, like, low-key rapping on it. I was like, well, this is, like, 19,
you
like, during
gotta,
the... During
you, def- the you definitely got to play a little.
Please, Phil.
During, like, the Good Times heyday,
please.
So, like...
For all the wonderful things that have happened in my life, I'd like to salute my elders with this song.
Yes, Esther.
Oh, God.
Yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
The name of her album was The Garden of My Mind.
As it should be titled, The Garden of Her Damn Mind. Where all this genius sprouted from. She let the choir have some space.
They were poor. They were humble.
They were humble.
But there was much.
Esther Rolle.
So
I
shout
love
out,
Esther
Rolle. Shout out to Esther Rolle for being that black mom.
I bet her potato salad good as
that's
shit.
That's what I'm saying. Like,
hold on.
She made good candied yams.
Tamone just said Jeffrey Rolle.
Jeffrey Rolle.
That was Kelly Price.
Yes.
Who yelled his name in a show I did many years ago. R&B Divas.
R&B Divas.
We love you, Kelly.
Yikes.
Listen.
Yikes. I was on R&B Divas.
Was I on R&B Divas? No, you were.
Yeah. With Kiki Wyatt.
Hey.
I remember that.
We got nominated for a Grammy together for R&B Damn
Divas.
We
sure did.
Tears of Joy, Faith Evans.
Tears of Joy. And that was the top five R&B single.
Yeah, that's right.
You know what I'm saying?
Someone I know.
Shout out to Fizzy Faith.
Heard that song for the first
Fizzy,
time.
Fizzy,
was crying
Fizzy Faith.
Really?
After they heard that song.
Tears of Joy, can I tell a secret story? Tears of Joy was originally. No, it wasn't for her. I don't know who we did it for originally, but Brandy was going to cut that song.
What?
Yeah.
She came to the studio.
She came to the studio.
Killed it.
Shout out to Esther Rolle for being that black mom and that black actress that always held us down throughout the years, and for your gospel album that we're just discovering and going through day by day. But the
Savoy Records, I need this on Spotify and Apple. We need Esther Rolle.
We need Esther Rolle out
on
there.
On all digital service providers.
The Garden of My Mind.
Yeah, please, Garden of My Mind.
Esther Rolle.
But the idea is that we're trying to honor people that don't normally get honored, but have been consistent in our cultural lives. So my question is, nominated for the Esther Rolle Award for Black Excellence, do we nominate Chrisette Michele? I'm nominating her, all right?
I know who I want to nominate.
I'm nominating Chrisette Michele. I'm being controversial here.
Who you nominating, Tamone?
Tamia.
Oh.
Every Tamia album is great to me.
Now,
every
one of them. Yeah, you know we love Tamia.
Every one of
them. That's
the
homie. Yeah.
Like she is to me. Is like every Tamia album I know from top to bottom.
Yeah, man.
I'm gonna go with Tamone. Tamia. here's my vote.
You gotta nominate someone yourself, homie.
I gotta nominate someone?
Because you could beat that. Maybe you could beat that.
But Tamia is a great one. But if I had to nominate someone, it's a dear friend of mine. We've been friends for close to 20 years. We met years ago on the Lilith Fair tour for Missy Elliott. Sarah McLachlan and a few other amazing women. She was singing background. Little Mo.
Ah, I love Lil Mo, man.
Lil Mo is part of the fabric.
Yes,
of our lives.
Mo is one of the most. Again, I had the pleasure of managing her for a few years, and we've been friends literally 1999. This makes 20 years.
Man, shout out Mo, man.
Shout out Mo.
She got hits.
The funny thing about it is I've literally never met Lil Mo. Never been in the same room as her.
We got to get her down here. But she would be. She
in
would,
my mind, I feel like. We would fucking kick it hard. Like I feel yeah, like man. I feel like we've already had a spades tournament together, and like we've been on the same team and kicked people's asses. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like she's a dope spades partner. That's how I fuck with her.
She's a hella spades partner.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, like, man.
She's a dope spades partner. That's a different. That's a black level of respect. So yeah. Okay. So who you nominating, Chuck?
I'm gonna have to nominate my girl Tweet.
Oh.
I'm gonna have to go with Tweet. Like, you know, I totally agree with Tamia, because Tamia one of my favorites. But Tweet, you know what I'm saying? Like, we were on the road in top of January, and we were playing Tweet all the way down, going from D.C. to New York, and we caught that vibe, man. It was just like, it felt like the first time I heard a new artist again.
Damn.
Like, she was
complicated.
She was such an original artist, yeah. Man. And she had a sound all her own. She had a perspective. She had a style. Missy was giving her records. Timbaland was giving her records. She had her own records. Oh, man.
I think whoever it is, now this is the twist of the curve. Yo, we got to call whoever it is and let them know that they won this award.
Yeah, man. We got to actually make an award.
We got to give them an award and give them their fucking
flowers.
With an
afro on it.
With an afro.
No, but we got to start giving people their flowers because they're not getting recognized.
That's
like,
the problem.
That's what happened to Esther. Ain't nobody even recognized. Ain't nobody know she had a gospel album.
True. No, the whole point is like this. It's how many people, everyone we mentioned here has done amazing things.
Yeah.
And definitely, they're all doing very well in their respect, but they could be a lot more celebrated and awarded and lifetime achievement and all that stuff.
Yeah.
So, fuck it, we gonna do it. Esther Rolle Award for Black Excellence
goes to who would you vote?
If I'm voting right now, even
I mean, let's show of hands.
All right,
how many people vote for Tamia?
Shit, that's all four
it's
of us.
Unanimous.
It's unanimous. It's unanimous.
How did that happen?
What about?
I don't know. We all nominated people for voting for Tamia.
We all sold our own selves out. We're like, oh my god.
We
bad.
All gave. Passionate responses about
for other people.
Yeah, but voted for Tamia.
There'll be episodes to come, but as I think about it, I feel
I'm
like
voting for Tweet again at some point.
I vote for Tweet. Tweet has my vote.
Who votes for Tweet?
Tweet? Okay, we got two for Tweet.
Who votes for Lil Mo?
Two for Meezy. We got you. Coming soon. And Chrisette Michele.
Two for Chrisette.
Tamia wins. But I think it makes sense. Like, yo, Tamia got discovered by Quincy Jones, y'all.
Yeah, man.
Come on. Like, she was on that Quincy album singing You Put Him Over My Heart and Slow Jams and all that stuff. And then she done put her own shit out. She's been remixed by hip hop on hit records.
Yeah.
And shout out for not ever having any bad performances.
Right.
That's the other thing. Like,
consistency.
When does Tamia ever sound bad?
Shout out to that.
Shout out to Excellence.
We sound crazy.
So you know what? I want to do a round. This is probably not a popular game, but I want to do a round of keep or kill.
Damn, dude.
And we love everybody, so we're not literally killing them, but if you had to pick one, because there's only one slot.
All right.
So keep or kill.
Okay.
Drum roll, please. That's good.
Thank you.
He's like, what am I thinking? Look at tomorrow. SWV. I said it again. SWV. SSSWV.
Sisters with the Voices.
Mm-hmm. And Escape.
Keep or Kill?
Keep or Kill.
That's so unfair because I love Candy.
I love Candy.
We love Candy.
We are killing Escape. Sorry. Yeah.
Tamone, you're killing Escape.
I'm killing Escape.
Not even without a...
No question.
No question for me neither.
Claude is what... Like,
Escape is gone. 6 feet under.
Chuck?
I love Candy, but you got to go with SWV. Rain is one of the best songs.
Best songs
time.
Ever, man. Come on. Brian, listen. Brian Alexander Morgan.
Yeah, like where you at? Where you at, Bam?
Come on.
Where you at, man?
Them songs, that arrangement, those vocals, him singing on the records.
Yes, man.
He tripping.
Wow. That was more overwhelming. That was, for the record, I'm SWV as well.
Man, listen, Coco's voice.
I love you, Candy, though.
So, we love Candy.
So favorite, is that SWV, is that your favorite group from the 90s? Like, when you think about the TLCs, the En Vogues, the Destiny's Child, like, is that your favorite group from the 90s?
When I look at groups, catalog standpoint, SWV.
Yes.
Really?
Definitely.
Those are the records that I always go back to.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's where I'm talking.
I'm going to forever play Rain. You know what I'm saying?
Like, or the whole New Beginning album from top to bottom.
Yeah, the whole first
me.
Album too.
Yeah.
The Human Nature remix to Right
yes.
Here.
Yes. Or the remix album.
You tripping. Dude.
Yeah, by the way, all those remixes of SWV are up on all the digital platforms now. Like the Right Here, Right Here, I'm So Into You.
Always
Downtown.
In my mind.
Yeah.
Downtown,
I love Downtown,
dude.
Downtown.
Week, all the different 20
week,
million yeah. versions of
like,
Week.
What are we talking about? We're
Missy
talking about
writing, Can We? Can't get a night. Listen, here's my tear is that as a kid, I was definitely a bigger TLC fan for all the cool
True.
Factor, colorful points, and I have a lot of nostalgia for them. Like, I love TLC as my favorite girl group for lots of other reasons, but SWV's music just stands the test of time a different kind of way.
It does.
Yeah.
It's
always going to be in rotation.
It
great
is.
Way to put it.
I love SWV.
I love them.
Can I mean, call? I'm
they're
call,
top. They're top five girl groups of all time for me.
Yeah.
Really?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
SWV.
Absolutely.
Where do they rank? Top five.
Well, up towards the top, you have the Supremes, the Clark Sisters. That's the Pointer Sisters.
Ooh, the Pointer Sisters.
Yeah, the Pointer Sisters might be my top.
It's not any specific order, but all those come before SWV. But SWV is like four or five for sure. And that's with a lot of respect. That's not to say like four or five isn't shabby at all. I'm talking about like in high esteem. Who you calling?
Hello? Hey, hey, Coco?
Huh?
This is Phil Thornton. How you doing? Okay, so full disclosure, I'm sitting here with my friends, Chuck Harmony, Claude Kelly, Tamone Bacon. We're doing our first podcast, and we were talking about the legacy, the impact of SWV. So this ain't no prepped. I didn't pre-produce you. This is just something. I said, I'm going to call and see if she pick up the phone.
Okay.
Yo, so we did a Keep or Kill segment of SWV and Escape.
Okay.
It was unanimous. SWV.
We gotta keep you.
No questions.
No.
Right.
Right. Exactly.
Coco, we gotta get you down here to the workshop here in Nashville. When I think about Right Here, I'm So Into You, Weak.
Yeah, man.
Rain.
The classics. Rain. Use your heart. Like, what's
use your heart.
You're the one. Anything?
Can yes. we?
Can we?
All that.
All that.
But Coco, I'm going with the album cuts though.
We love you.
We love you for sure.
Coco, how you doing, baby? We here. We in Nashville. We waiting on you.
Come through.
Just say when. I would definitely come through, honey.
Congrats. Lil Tracy on the cover of Faded this month. That's amazing. Shout out.
Yes, I'm so proud of him. You know, he's come a long way.
All right, Coco, I just want to shout you. Congratulations, SWV.
Keep it
cool.
SWV, the throne, baby.
The throne.
Legendary. Legends.
Legendary.
Love you. Thank you.
All right, babe.
Bye. Amazing.
Wow.
Yeah, man.
You just called.
You just called the legend.
Icons on the phone. You know what I'm saying?
Icons.
We sound crazy.
What are you thinking, Claude? What are you thinking, Chuck? Tamone, what you thinking? What's this? Send them off in a positive way.
Send them off with some Curtis, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, Curtis.
Some people get ready.
Send off some people get ready.
People get ready.
Black men united, you will know.
Oh, yeah.
I love y'all.
That's awesome.
Until next time, God bless you.
Now the train are coming.
You don't need no baggage, you just get on board. All you need is faith
to hear the Jesus humming.
You don't need no ticket, you just think.